I wrote few articles in our CME India website about the mitochondrial induced endothelial cell dysfunction in diabetes progression, and I gave a slogan that make your mitochondria green on this World Diabetes Day. This is available because this is really very, very interesting science. Reversing the mitochondrial dysfunction is a game changer in diabetes. Remember, we are well aware, I'm not going to tell about that, what is type 2 diabetes, what is happening in it. There is some beta cell dysfunction, there is insulin resistance, and ultimately everything is happening at the molecular level, and that we are going to discuss about the things. So you can, what you can see here, that here the signal is red. This could be due to many things like mechanical stress is happening in your life. You are getting then high glucose. There is hypoxia, ultimately leading to mitochondrial lots of changes. But remember, this can be made green. And this can be done by many things, not only the therapeutic targets of some drugs, but apart from that, your caloric restriction, your antioxidants, your physical exercise, many things can reverse that. So we'll talk about that. You see here that mitochondria are integral to the pancreatic beta cell function and survival. And type 2 diabetes, there are so many pro-inflammatory cytokines are coming. ROS there, AG there, oxidized LDL is there, and leading to microvascular complications and complications, and lots of complications that is happening. So there, diabetology had a very beautiful issue on the mitochondria in obesity and type 2 diabetes, how this can be the damaging and how it could be the protection. So today, targeting mitochondria is a great boon to fight type 2 diabetes. And we have got some sort of pharmacotherapy like bagonides, glitazones, GLP-1, SGLT2 inhibitors. We have got exercise and diet, but mitochondrial targeted molecules are also in the forefront coming up. And this shows how even a simple can be a green. I'm not going to tell for that. This is just showing how even doing exercise every day, there are lots of key genes are regulated by the exercise, by genetic variation, transcriptional factors, and other things. And before I start going to the details of the pharmaceuticals or pharmaceuticals of the some molecules, remember your oversupply and your metabolic undersupply. This will lead you for the longevity. This will lead you for the reversal of things. And this is nothing more you need if you understand why it is happening. And this is beautifully explained in this paper. When there is oversupply, your mitochondria go to the respiratory deficiency leading to fission. You can see in that part here, a bikhrav ho jata hai, toot jata hai. And the moment there is undersupply, it becomes a fusion. And if you can understand this great science, nothing more is to be done here. So chronic episodes of metabolic oversupply may fragment the mitochondrial network. So in diabetes, if you are going to treat someone, you have to take care of it. That conditions that favor the metabolic undersupply induce mitochondrial fusion. As a result, preserve the mitochondrial DNA integrity and optimal function, which may promote optimal physiological adaptation and healthy aging. With that, increase your mitochondrial function in order to prevent or treat diabetes and keep them young. This is, I think, one of the best slogan which you can remember. So diabetes today is considered a phenotype of mitochondrial dysfunction, remember? And pathogenesis of diabetes, you can see here, there's in pancreas, you have got the liver, you have got the skeletal muscle, you have got the adipose tissue. And lots of things happening. You can see the ROS generation, ATP synthesis, disruption. And everything is happening where? It is happening at the mitochondrial level. So in update 2024 is that the mitochondrial dysfunction has long been associated with diabetes as a potential cause of both insulin resistance and beta cell dysfunction, and more recently in the context of secondary diabetes complications. Here we are not discussing the mitochondrial diabetes, that is a different thing. If there is in the chromosome of the mitochondria, there is even the 10.4 kb deletion of the DNA, the genetic form of a typical diabetes occurs, that is known as mitochondrial disease. Here you are discussing that normal type 2 diabetes. So you can see here the imbalance in which ATP levels are compromised and mitochondria play a crucial role, you are well aware. So there is clear-cut mitochondrial dysfunction in type 2 diabetes. An influence of oxidative stress on mitochondrial dysfunction, insulin resistance, diabetes. Remember, this is happening in the very big way. And I'm not going details, but mitochondrial impairment and structural destruction leads to accumulation of ROS. Then this accumulation, which within mitochondria induces apoptosis by the oxidation of the cardiolipin. And excess ROS is released into the cytosol of beta cell and oxidized proteins, lipids, and carbohydrates. And additionally, ROS can modify the DNA structure to inhibit insulin expression. And these processes result in diabetes. Even though if you have got lots of fatty acid increased in mitochondria, it will lead to insulin resistance and the reduced glucose uptake. And ultimately, what is going to happen? There is mitophagy, apoptosis. So even the beta cell mass will reduce, beta cell secretion will reduce, and apart from so many things I showed you, there will be insulin resistance. So there is decreased mitochondrial biogenesis, and we have to think about that, how we are going to improve this biogenesis. Now let us see, when you are going to treat a case of type 2 diabetes, what you have got with this background, where what is happening inside the mitochondria. So how to improve this? So we have got many agents today. You can see here, the mitochondrial dysfunction is a significant factor in development of type 2 diabetes. Lots of things are there, but remember that tissue target at adipose tissue and skeletal muscles. Today we have got a metformin and glitazones. At pancreas, you want to increase the insulin secretion, we have got the sulfonylurea or insulin. At the kidney, we have got beautiful drug SGLT2 inhibitors. At the liver, you have got again biogonerides and glitazones. And glucose absorption, you have got this alpha glucosidase inhibitors. But these are the main effects which we are going there. But what the metformin, what is the potency of metformin in doing anything on the mitochondria? There are some mechanisms which are being questioned that even the mitochondrial function improves by the use of this metformin. But I will not go in detail of that because it is not too much in the research mode that can prove that. But there are some sort of beneficial effects again with the glitazones. Results of some studies are not conclusive, so I believe again it is not conclusive. Even if you think about the SGLT2 inhibitors, they also inhibit the complex 1 respiration in primary mouse hepatocytes and to increase the expression of proteins important for the mitochondrial biogenesis. So far, due to molecular mechanisms of SGLT2 inhibitors demonstrated in cell and animal models so far, they might be assigned a respiratory complex 1 inhibitor or PPAR agonist pharmacoreaction in the future, but today we don't have the proper thing. Ab ek kahawat hai Bihar mein ki upar se feet fat aur niche se mukama ghat. I think go and read about what is the mukama ghat. It is a very, very important place in Bihar. So far in the history, when there was a Bengal famine, and it is a very important place, but lots of infamous stories are with the mukama ghat. So I think let us see ki Meglin, when we talk about this molecule, a drug with dual mechanism of action that is designed to increase insulin secretion also in response to glucose and to improve insulin resistance, why it is not happening that such a beautiful molecule is propping up in the market? When we talk to my colleagues, even Dr. Srinivasa Murthy and other many I taught, they are not at all happy with molecule. Why it is happening? We are well up here, know that this is a approved novel drug for the type 2 diabetes, approved in Japan in 2021. Then later in 2022, it was approved by our DCGI. It has got also a preclinical and so many clinical studies. And remember that this is the only compound with a dual mechanism of action that is directly designed both to increase insulin secretion in response to glucose and to improve insulin resistance. And firstly, this will show you that effects of this molecule happening to increase the glucose utilization, decrease in the gluconeogenesis, increase in glucose utilization, and increase in the insulin secretion, and decrease in beta cell apoptosis. If this is happening, then I think this is, will should be the ideal molecule which we should tackling everything in our body. So this provides a novel approach to treatment of type 2 diabetes due to its unique dual mode of action. And this is just revealed, I think, with very 2024 article showing that how this is doing. We are decreasing the ER resistance, stress, decreasing beta cell death. So there is functional beta cell mass increase also. So this is a peculiar molecule. They're also increasing the beta cell mass. Insulin secretion is also coming up. And gluconeogenesis in liver is increasing, and insulin sensitivity also at the liver and muscle cells. If this is happening in reality, then I think this is the only molecule we should use. But this is not, so I'm not going to detail of the mechanism of action. I have 2 or 3 minutes more. But this molecule by which improves glucose homeostasis by insulin sensitivity, I told you about gluconeogenesis, beta cell function, everything. And if you see the here, I think only 3 ticks is with this molecule. Everywhere your insulin sensitivity, beta cell stimulation action on the mitochondria, so this itself tells you everything. So possible beneficial effects are on the endothelium. Now the things are changing a bit. In the 2024, lots of paper are coming which say that even at the brain level, at the heart level, at kidney level, it is doing beautiful work. And by that even many complications which is happening in diabetes, all these complications of the diabetic vascular disease, metabolic cardiomyopathy, your this NFLD, obesity, everything can be tackled by this molecule, but we don't have proper research today like EMPA-REG and CANVASTAL and other things which show that, but still these are all animal studies and showing beautiful results. If you saw this is oral drug, you can sort of give by 1 gram milligram BD, very low protein binding is there, very low hepatic metabolism, urinary excretion of unchecked drugs, no drug-drug interaction, no QT prolongation. So what I find, ki whatever the issues are with other molecules, it is not at all with this molecule. Still it is not propping up. You can see here how this plasma protein binding, the transport proteins, a dual phase metabolic process, even the absorption part is very, very good. Even the metabolism in the liver is minimal and pharmacokinetics is very good. And even in the special situations, like hepatic patients, safe and well tolerated, see here. Even in the pregnancy, it should not be given, that is a contraindication. Lactation, consider continuing or discontinuing breastfeeding, talking into the account, and therapeutic benefits and benefits of breastfeeding. But even in the CKD, I think this should be remembered, that the latest thing is that for type 2 diabetes, if there is EGFR stage 3B, or the EGFR is 30 to 40 in a stage 4, I think EGFR 15-29, the CKD, the Japanese PMDA only advised reduced dose of 500 BD. But remember today, the Indian regulator suggested that this molecule should not be used at any dose in type 2 diabetes with CKD of a stage 3B and above. But in Japan, they are not following this. So this shows you the insulin secretion and sensitivity increases. If you want about some papers, there we have got lots of papers. I will just finish it very fast. That absence of QTC prolongation, and let us see the clinical data. Today, I think the only guideline which tells you to use this molecule is only from the Japan. Apart from that, in the world, no one, even the RSSDI, even the IDA, anything, no one is using, but here Emeglin is mentioned. And we have got in the basis of the times 1, times 2, and times 3 study, efficacy and safety of the study, everyone is showing a very beautiful decrease in HbA1c. You can see here the times 3 study also, which is the latest one. And phase 3 clinical trial report also, the Indian study is showing in the same way, although the data is here, you can see here the mean change in the glycated hemoglobin, mean change to fasting to or PP. And systemic review and meta-analysis, 2 are very important. One is from Dr. Avdhesh Kumar Singh. He has done a beautiful meta-analysis, and that tells about in favor that meta-analysis using the random effects model from the 2 monotherapy studies, that this molecule significantly lowers the HbA1c against placebo. And this is the last study by systemic review, which shows a very, very important message again, that it works very well. When given as a monotherapy, BD dose, 100 1 gram was associated with a greater reduction in HPV 1 HE. The two meta-analysis is very important, and conclusion of this study that there is no significant difference in the incidence of any side effects or other things. I'm not going to detail.
Dr. N.
Lastly, sir, one last question, sir. Last is that this is a very important molecule, and this dysfunction plays an essential role in type 2 diabetes, improves the insulin sensitivity, enhances beta cell function, improves mitochondrial dysfunction, potential to treat diabetic complications, and works synergistically with the other anti-diabetic drugs. किसी के साथ दे दो, इसको कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है. थैंक यू वेरी मच. आई थिंक आई हैव गिवन माय मैसेज.